Hello and welcome back. My name is Raymond Gabriel. This is the second part of the 2D character animation tutorial. In the last part, we learned how to separate this character from the background and importing it into Blender. If you'd like to watch the last part, the link is in the description. If you want to get right into animation, you can download the blend file and the images used from a link in the description below, so you can follow along if you want. Without any further delay, let's get right into it. To animate, let's make a very simple rig for this mesh. Press Shift and right-click on the character to change the location of the 3D cursor. Any new added meshes or objects are added at the location of the 3D cursor. Press Shift plus A and from Armature, select Single Bone. Then go to Edit Mode by pressing Tab and then Edit Mode. Scale it down by pressing S. Then move the bone by pressing G. Select the end of the bone and press E to extend a new bone. Let's repeat that to make a new bone. To make a separate new bone, while in Edit Mode, press Shift plus A. Select the new bone, scale it down by pressing S, and move it by pressing G, and rotate it like that by pressing R. Then press Shift plus D to duplicate this bone here. Let's get out of Edit Mode, press Tab, and choose Object Mode. To attach this mesh to the rig, let's choose the mesh first, then press Shift, and then choose the rig. Now, press Ctrl P to parent the armature to the mesh, and select Automatic Weights. If everything is done correctly, we should now be able to animate this mesh by selecting the rig and then press Tab and go to Pose Mode, select this bone and try to rotate with R. Okay, great. You can change the influence each bone have on the mesh by weight painting. The automatic weights have done a good job, but let's see how we can change the weights so we can customize the influence of the bones if we want. To do that, we have to select the character mesh while in pose mode. First, we have to disable lock object mode from here. Press edit and remove this check mark beside lock object mode. Now select the character mesh, then press tab and select weight paint. I can now change the influence of individual bones. To select bones, while pressing Ctrl, select any of the bones. These colors represent the influence that these bones have on the mesh. The red color means that this part of the mesh is most influenced by this bone, and green means medium influence, and blue means zero influence. I can now choose the bone that I want, and paint the red color on the part I want this bone to influence. I can go here and change the weight that I want to paint with, or I can change it directly from the viewport by selecting View and enabling Tool Settings from here. Great! After we are done weight painting, we are ready to start animating the rig. Let's make a very simple animation. Go to Object Mode by pressing Tab, select the rig, press Tab and go to Pose Mode, select all bones by pressing A, then press I to insert a keyframe at frame 1. You can see the frame that you are on from this timeline. We are now at frame 1. Press I, then select Location, Rotation, Scale. Let's say we want this character to bend over in 24 frames. Move the marker to 24, or change the frame from here and draw directly 24. Now, rotate the bones you want. Then, press A to select all bones again. Press I and choose Location, Rotation, Scale. Let's play the animation. Press this button to return to frame 1, then press play. I've only gone through the basics here, just to have an idea of the workflow. To finish up, let's render out the project. Go to the Render tab. Remember, we talked about the render engines, we can change them from here. We can choose between Eevee or Cycles. I recommend using Eevee to render this out, as it will render super fast. If you want, you can change it to Cycles. But notice, now we have very hard shadows of the character on the plane behind. To remove it, select the character, go to Object tab, and from Visibility, uncheck Shadow. Let's change it back to Eevee. Go to Output tab, select the start and end frames you want to render. we only animate 24 frames, so change the end to 24. Change from here the output location and choose allocation. You can change the file format from here. I prefer to leave it as it is and render the frames as PNG. Now go to render and select render animation or press Ctrl F12. The render has started. As you can see, Eevee is really fast. Done! You have 24 rendered frames. You can use it in any video editing software. We can see how to do that later with DaVinci Resolve. We have overviewed the whole process I use to create my 2D animations, but a lot can be discussed later in detail. I hope you found this series useful. I will keep making new tutorials like this as much as I can. Please subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified as soon as new videos are uploaded. If you'd like to see more content more often, you can back me up on Patreon. You can get in touch with me and there is a lot of perks I'm offering. Check it out from the link in the description. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you in the next tutorial.